The Space Orc Raiders were the marauding horde of the first edition of Warhammer 40,000, known as Rogue Trader. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to quickly paint an Orc boy in the retro style of the Space Orc Raiders using the modern Citadel paints. So, the first thing that we're going to need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we're using Grey Sear. Now this is a great starting point for the contrast paints that we'll be using. We're also going to use Grey Sear from the pot in order to tidy up any mistakes or spills that we do along the way before going on to the rest of the layers. So, the first paints that we're going to need are going to be Gore Grunter Fur, Wildwood, Iron Hand Steel, and Iron Warriors. So let's get some Gore Grunter Fur onto the paintbrush. So I'm just going to get it here straight from the pot. Then what I want to do is start picking out all the details that I want to use Gore Grunter Fur for. As you can see, I've got a really good dollop on my paintbrush, and I'm just going to keep the paint moving, just allowing it to flow into the recesses. With that section complete, you can see the trousers and gloves have been picked out. We now need to move on to Wildwood in order to pick out the rest of the leather details. So it's going to be the boots here and all the straps and pouches on the model. With the Wildwood applied, we now need to move on to all of the silver details. And for this, we're going to be using Iron Hand Steel. So I'm just going to be picking out some details that I want to be silver across the model. However, I'm not going to pick out all of them because we're going to go for that two-tone effect that you see on the retro style of the Space Orc Raiders. With the first section of metal details picked out, we're now going to use Iron Warriors to pick out the rest of them. And there we go, with that stage complete, the metallic details are now finished. As you can see here, I've tidied up the unpainted areas using Grey Sear as well. What we need to do next is change the water pot because you don't want to get any of those metallic flakes into the rest of your paints. Once you've done that, we're going to move on to the rest of the contrast paints. And for this, we're going to be using Sigvald Burgundy, Blood Angels Red, Apothecary White, Gut Ripper Flesh, Space Wolves Grey, and Skeleton Horde. So, let's get some Sigvald Burgundy onto our paintbrush. So I'm just going to get it straight from the pot here. Just control how much I've got. Then what I want to do is just apply that onto the tongue. With the tongue picked out, we now need to do the war paint that the Space Orc Raiders had. And for this, we're going to be using Blood Angels Red. So as you see here, I'm just going to apply a line down the center. Just like that. Just to give me a rough idea of where the center line is, and then start filling in all the areas that I want to be red for the war paint. With the red complete, we now need to use Apothecary White for the other half of the war paint. With the war paint complete, we're now going to use Gut Ripper Flesh for the skin details. When doing this, once the paint is dry, run some more Gut Ripper Flesh into the recesses. This will help to give the muscles some extra definition. With the skin complete, we're now going to use Space Wolves Grey and apply that onto his shirt. Once the first layer is dry, just apply a second layer straight into the recesses. With the shirt now blocked in, the next thing that we need to do is to move on to using Skeleton Horde to pick out all the bone, teeth, and nail details on the model. And And with that stage complete, we now need to move on to applying shade to the model. And for this, we're going to be using non-oil and applying that over all of the metallic areas. So let's get some non-oil onto our paintbrush. So I'm just going to get a dollop of non-oil here straight onto the brush. Just load it up. And then just start applying that all over the metallic areas. Just take your time when doing this and going around any of the other details. And there we go, with the non-oil dry, we now need to move on to doing the highlights. And for the highlights, we're going to be using Stormhost Silver, Screaming Skull, White Scar, and Fire Dragon Bright as our first highlights. So what we need to do is get some Stormhost Silver onto the palette. So I'm just gonna get a dollop here. Get it onto the palette. Just use a little bit of water just to thin it out, and then start rolling my brush to a nice sharp point, just by twisting it like that. And then what I want to do is start picking out all the edges of the metallic details. Just remember to use the side of your brush when doing this to make it a lot easier and quicker for yourself. And there we go, with metallic details edge highlighted, we now need to move on to doing the brown and leather details. And for this, we're going to be using Screaming Skull as a dry brush highlight, and then afterwards doing an edge highlight just to pick up some areas here and there. So let's get some Screaming Skull onto the brush. So I'm just gonna get it straight from the pot here, and then apply it onto this paper I have. So I'm just gonna get as much of the paint off as I can by brushing it into the paper. What this will do is dry out the bristles as well as push the pigment into the bristles as well. And this will make it really easy to do the dry brush. So as you see, I'm just doing a test here, seeing if I'm happy with it. Yeah, that's good. And then what I want to do is lightly brush over all the brown details. This could be on his trousers as well as his wristbands. And then when that's done, moving on to the bone and the teeth. With the dry brush highlight over the brown details finished, we're now going to use Screaming Skull as an edge highlight just to pick out the most raised details. With all the brown details now dry brushed and edge highlighted, we need to move on to doing the white war paint. And for this, we're going to be using White Scar just to edge highlight all the raised areas. With the white side of the war paint relayered, we're now going to use Fire Dragon Bright in order to edge highlight the raised details of the red side of the war paint. When we finish doing that, we're also going to use Fire Dragon Bright to pick out the eyes. With the red war paint now edge highlighted, we need to move on to the rest of the highlight details. And for this, we're going to be using Phalanx Yellow, Leviadon Blue, and Blue Horror. So let's get some Phalanx Yellow onto the palette.
I'm just going to get a dollop of Phalanx Yellow here, get it onto the palette, and then immediately just start twisting the brush, getting a little bit of water, adding to it because it is quite thin already. And then twist. Yeah, happy with that. Nice sharp point.
And then what we're going to do is just do a tiny dot in the middle of the eye. With the eye picked out, we're now going to use Phalanx Yellow again as a dry brush highlight over all the raised details of the skin. Just very gently brushing over all the raised muscles.
A good tip here, if you found that you've overdone the yellow on the green skin, just use Gut Ripper Flesh again, straight from the pot, just to tone down those areas.
With the skin complete, we now need to do the camo patterns that the Space Orc Raiders were famous for, and for this we're going to be using Leviathan Blue. The camo pattern is like a tiger stripe, so we're going to do this by painting the lines across the shirt using Leviathan Blue, just like this. Once you're happy with the area, just fill it in, and then go all across the shirt doing the same thing. With the tiger pattern established, the next thing that we need to do is use Blue Horror in order to pick up all the raised details of the shirt, as well as painting just above the higher line of each tiger pattern. So what I mean by that is just doing this here. So where this pattern is down here. And at the same time, you're also picking out all the raised edges of the shirt. With the Blue Horror applied, the shirt highlights are now complete. What we need to focus on next is doing the base, and for this we're going to be needing Mechanicus Standard Grey, Armageddon Dunes, Seraphim Sepia, and Screaming Skull. So, let's get some Mechanicus Standard Grey onto the palette.
I'm just going to get a dollop here of Mechanicus Standard Grey, get it onto the palette, a little bit of water just to thin it out.
And then what I want to do is just pick out the rock that the Space Orc Raider is standing on. With the rock complete, we now need to focus on adding the texture, and for this we're going to be using Armageddon Dunes. Right, so let's get some Armageddon Dunes onto our texture tool.
So I'm just going to use the large flat end of the textures tool here, just to scoop up the Armageddon Dunes, just like that.
And then apply it onto the base. So I'm going to put just like that there. And then use the smaller area of the texture tool just to push it around the base. Just be careful when going around the model's feet, but don't worry if you get too much on the feet, because it just helps to tie the model in with the base.
As always, when applying the texture, once you've completed getting it onto the base, remember just to let it stand and dry for around an hour in order to let it take effect.
Now that the texture is dry, we're going to apply Seraphim Sepia all over it. We're also going to apply it onto the rock. With that stage complete, we now need to use Screaming Skull as a dry brush highlight over the texture and the rock. When doing this, just remember to do it in nice circular motions, because this will give a really nice natural highlight to the texture. And there we go, the dry brush highlight is complete. What we need to do next is add some Mordian Corpse Cross tufts to the base. So let's go ahead and do that.
So I'm just going to get a tuft here.
Apply it to the base just like that, where I want it. Then use my texture tool just to press down on it. The good thing here is that underneath the tuft, there's some adhesive, so you don't need to use any glue if you don't want to. So I'm just going to get that tuft there, and then I'm just going to add a couple of more to the base. And there we go. With the tufts applied, our Space Orc Raider is now complete. All that's left to do is to paint the rim of the base. And as you see here, we've done that using Steel Legion Drab, but you can do it in whatever color matches the rest of your army. With the base completed and the rim painted, our Rogue Trader inspired Space Orc Raider is ready to loot and pillage the galaxy in the name of the WAAAGH. So, there are just a couple of things to remember. When using contrast paints as base coats, it's a good idea to start with the darker paints first and then work your way towards the lighter ones like we did in the video. Also, try and use the contrast paints to your advantage by letting them dry and then applying the contrast again in the recesses to act as natural shading. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own retro Space Orc Raiders from Warhammer 40,000 Rogue Trader. And we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.